believe the Lord's impressing it upon me as He's restored our marriage, as He's making it new. Hey everybody, thank you so much for clicking on this video. Out of all of the godly marriage videos that you could have chosen to watch, you clicked on this one. Thank you very much. I believe the Lord has a word for you and your godly marriage today. So here's the truth. I've been a Christian YouTuber for over 3 years. There's been times that I've shared my heart and I've been completely transparent, but I've never really talked to you too terribly much about marriage. In today's video, I want to talk about having a godly marriage that leads to winning souls for the Lord, how to have a godly marriage, and is that even possible in 2020? I am going to share with you some personal and vulnerable experiences in an attempt to express that God, through His beautifully designed plan of godly marriage, can restore and transform your marriage from what it was to what He's calling it to be. If that's something that interests you, please consider watching to the very end. If you're not subscribed, go ahead and tap that red subscribe button. When you do, a little tiny church bell will pop up, and if you tap that, you'll be notified every time I post a video. Right now, I'm recording a video every day in the month of August, and then I will return to a twice-a-week posting schedule. I'd love to have you a part of what I lovingly call our kingdom crew. Let's talk about godly marriage. Okay, everybody, so I'm going to read a scripture out of my women's Bible that I am reading. If you're interested in checking this Bible out, I'll place a link to a review I did on it below so you can check it out. So this is the NLT, and I'm going to read in 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 10, and it reads, "In His kindness, God called you to share in His eternal glory by means of Christ Jesus. So after you have suffered a little while, He will restore, support, and strengthen you, and He will place you on a firm foundation. All power to Him forever. Amen." So that's 1 Peter 5, 10, and 11. So let's talk about suffering for a little while. I think that God is just calling me to a place of being completely real and transparent on this channel. I believe that now more than ever, in order to have a godly marriage, it's important that we know that those people that we look to in our lives, whom we think have this amazing godly marriage and they win souls to the Lord and they're doing amazing things and they're doing all of this kingdom work, their ministries are thriving, their homes are beautiful, they have Instagram perfect lives. It's important to understand that even in those godly marriages that there is suffering for a little while. And what do I mean by that? What I mean is that you hear people when they counsel others about marriages, even godly marriages, that not everyone's going to be happy all the time. I want to share with you that in my personal marriage, I have really, really struggled. I won't go into very in-depth examples, but I will just tell you that communication has always been an issue. And I believe that it is an issue in every godly marriage. But here's the thing. At times, it almost has felt as though we've been moments away from divorce. Even godly marriages that need to be transformed and restored and made new, even those godly marriages, they go through seasons. I would encourage you that if you are in the midst of a broken marriage, but you're a believer in Christ, if you and your husband attend church, if you're seeking a godly marriage, but you both feel like you're giving 110 and you both feel like you're in a season of suffering, I want to encourage you in that you can use those broken pieces in your marriage. God can restore them and transform them and make your godly marriage one in which people see Jesus. I know it feels impossible. It has felt impossible for years in my life, but God is restoring and transforming, and souls will be won to the kingdom because of the love that you have for your spouse. Did you know that in godly marriages, people are actually watching you? They're not only watching you, but they're thinking, if that's the way a Christian husband and wife treats each other, whether good or bad, I do or don't want to serve the God they serve. Did you know, I had the realization today after listening to some things, that God can use your godly marriage as a tool so that you can be soul winners. When I heard those words today, I was perplexed at every side. I know that there has been suffering and pain for a season in my godly marriage, but God is restoring, God is transforming, and we will win souls as a result of the Christ that is in us, the love that we have for Christ and one another as we continuously pour out and serve one another. Every godly marriage needs to have a firm foundation on God. After all, that's what makes it a godly marriage. If your marriage needs renewed, if you're in a broken, destitute place, if you're overwhelmed, you're just ready to throw in the towel, you don't know which way to turn, because ladies and gentlemen, I have been there. I have been there. I am only being transparent with you to tell you that God turns it around. God restores godly marriages. Those who are seeking Him first above all things, like Matthew 6 and 33 teaches us to do, God will turn it around. I want to encourage you in this final tip today to be careful. What you speak out of your mouth is what you will get. The power of life and death is in the tongue. If you speak good things about your marriage, if you're positive about it being transformed, being made new, God is going to take your broken pieces and souls are going to see what's happening in your marriage, in the way you treat one another, in the way that you act towards one another. And He's going to show people through your godly marriage that He can restore. People need restoration. In 2020, people's lives are broken and falling apart for many different reasons. Godly marriages are so, so vitally important. I implore you, don't give up. Don't throw in the towel. Comment below godly marriage. If you are in the midst of situations in your marriage and you need prayer, you can always DM me on Instagram. You can always comment below unspoken, and I'll know that you in some degree need prayer for your godly marriage. If you're single and you're seeking a godly marriage, comment below unspoken. I'll add you to the list. We need to bind together. The enemy wants nothing more than to destroy our homes. But if we speak life into our marriages, if we're working together, that is the final piece I'll leave you with today. Both parties working together. And if you're fighting independently, maybe you're the only believer, or maybe you're the only one actively trying to cause God to pour out that restoration, don't give up hope and don't throw in the towel. It's not over till God says it's over. He will have the final say. There is pain, there is hurt for a season, but God makes all things new, and God will create beauty from your ashes. I plan on making more godly marriage videos. I believe the Lord's impressing it upon me as He's restored our marriage, as He's making it new, as He's making a new godly marriage where souls will be won as a result of the interaction in my godly marriage. He will do the same for you. Thank you so much for watching today's video. Comment godly marriage below. Let me know that you watched the entire video. Subscribe to the channel. There's going to be plenty more content just like this one. I've created a playlist called Godly Marriage. It will be in the description below. And if you are new here and you want to know what this channel is all about, check out this video right here that YouTube seems to think that you haven't seen yet, and this playlist to get caught up on all the videos that I've shared this month. And tap that picture right there of my ugly mug to subscribe to the channel. Stay kingdom-minded in all you do, and I will see you in the next video.